Certainly, there were lots of things that were a struggle about tonight, and we made lots of changes. We were looking for a combination that might help us win and keep the match alive in the fourth set. And so I commended them afterwards. This was a really nice win because it was so ugly and such a struggle at times. It's a good one to put in the bank, put in the account in terms of, I know, I've been to a lot of big tournaments, and there are going to be matches like this. Well, the great teams figure out a way to make plays even when it is a struggle. I wouldn't call us a great team yet, but we aspire to be one, and if we can make some matches happen like this, that's a nice thing to have in the account. So just as importantly, or maybe more so, thank you all for your support. Really appreciate what a great crowd you and everybody else out there were. Couple of fantastic nights of volleyball. It wasn't always pretty, but it sure was exciting, and everybody got into it here. We loved playing here, and hope to be able to come back again sometime soon, bring another good team. Maybe you can get to see one of the other top-ranked teams in the world. So, thank you. And any questions? Any quick questions? Yes, Don.
I noticed they played maybe just 9 gals and number 1 and 6, and that's their first team, and you rotated everybody in. Is that correct?
We played 4 matches against Brazil, and we started 4 different starting lineups. You could see it was significantly different tonight than it was last night, and significantly different on Sunday when we played in match number 2 at USC's Galen Center in Southern California. It was significantly different than the night before. You saw that Feluca Akinrodwo, one of the best middles in the world, played last night, but she did not play tonight. That's a part of her, I guess, the path that she's on. And she's been going through lots of long rehabilitation. She's finally getting to a really good and healthy place, and we want to keep her there for the long term. So we didn't want to push it here, but we'll see how the rest of the year goes and beyond. And I'm very thankful that we were developing a deep program. We have lots of different players that, as you pointed out, we can put on the court and make some good things happen. It's not always going to turn out to be a win, but they're developing confidence in themselves, and certainly they're developing confidence from their teammates and from their coaches. We can put lots of people out, and we have a lot of trust and belief that they can make some good things happen, and that's a nice thing to do against a great, great Brazilian program, the number 1 ranked team in the world. And again, we're very fortunate that they would come so far. It's a big, big trek, a big haul to come from Brazil just to Southern California, let alone to make another big flight all the way out here. But we're honored to be here, and we hope to get back out here again sometime soon and put on another nice volleyball show for you. So, nice question. Any others? Yes.
Have a silly question. Have you ever?
Oh, the silliest ones are the best ones.
Have you ever lost a
Robinson
serve in round 4 hours?
Yes.
Have you ever lost?
We have. The hardest hitting serves that we've had in our gym are around 61, 62 miles an hour. That's a nice pace. Comes down pretty hard. The men, somebody like Clay Stanley's been clocked at 82, 83. So for the men, that's a great speed. For the women, 60 plus is really good. You can see, though, that it's when you're hitting it that hard, sometimes it's difficult to keep it in a lot, and so that tends to be a little more error prone. But we don't mind a mix of servers to have on the court at the same time. When you have somebody who jumps and hits that jump spin serve, and then some float come, and then more jump spin, it kind of keeps the passers in a little different rhythm and keeps them switching it up a little. So that's a nice combination to have. We had it last night with Jordan Larson, Burbach, and Kelsey, both hitting their jump serve, and Kelly Murphy. And then tonight we have people like Nick Fawcett and Kelsey still, and then Kelly came in the game. So they're still working on that. They hit for too many errors right now, but they're learning and getting better, and that's the most important thing. It's not where we are now. It's where we're going to be in a month, in a year, hopefully in 2 years on this quest that Kevin mentioned, this quest to try to make history, to do something this team's never done before. And it's come awfully close. Come close to winning the Olympics, come close to winning the World Cup, come close to winning the World Championships. It's not done it yet. I don't know when that day is going to come, but my job is to try to help our job, this program's job, is to try to help that happen sooner rather than later. Yes?
All the coaches were wearing something on your belt. What was that?
That's a communication system. And about 4 points into last night, I threw mine in frustration under the chair because it was screaming in my ear, and there was this feedback, and I couldn't hear anything. I felt like I was going to blast my eardrum out. So we have the coaches on the bench are talking to somebody who sits in the end zone and get a different view of how the play is developing, getting some other specific sets of statistical data, and so they communicate back and forth. And I would be on that line normally too, but these two matches, the feedback was just so bad that I gave it up, and I'm just going so low and checking in with my coaches every once in a while. Normally, we like to have a little better communication system. That's something that we got to get better as this year progresses. Yes?
Can you keep the stats on each player
Oh yeah, we take lots and lots and lots of stats and numbers on every, we have somebody grading every touch that is made on our side of the net and on the other side of the net. Every serve, every pass, every set, every attack, every block, and every defensive play.
And do you have any communication with that during the game?
I don't know if you saw, but there's a computer sitting on our bench. We get one of those, and so the three of us will take a look at those various real-time, live-time stats. They're updated once every minute, and so they're completely up-to-date, and I'm looking especially at things like who's serving effectively, who's passing effectively, how our hitting is in terms of trying to decide what substitutions to make. I'm not the only one. The Brazilians do it too, and in fact, it looks like some of them are here. In fact, let's get Zay up here.